Hi class, welcome to another tutorial on pandas. This time we will learn how to handle duplicates in pandas. So duplicate data is often a major cause of concern when you do data analytics and all. So let us now just see how do we handle duplicates. So first we create a data frame having duplicate entries. So what do? We have our original movie data frame. So once again going back, so we have the IMDb movie database stored as a data frame, movies underscore data frame. So what I do, it has an append function, right? So what does the append function do? It tries to append two data frames. So see, what I'm trying to do here in the movies data frame, which is already a data frame of 1000 rows and 11 columns, I'm trying to append the same data frame to it. So what will happen? It will combine two data frames and you can see the shape of it. Now it has become 2000 rows and 11 columns. So in terms of files, what I will see is, like, for example, I had 1000 rows. I am appending the same 1000 rows below this. So it becomes a data frame of 2000 rows and 11 columns, right? Now the pandas provides us with a very powerful function known as drop duplicates, right? So drop duplicate will by default basically check for the which rows are entirely in duplicacy, right? So for example, when I say drop duplicates and when I see this, so basically I stored this appended data frame into temp underscore df, and now I'm asking pandas to read this data frame, which of course has 2000 rows and we know that it has duplicate for every row, and then drop the duplicates. So the moment I drop the duplicates, you can see basically the temp now is having 1000 rows and 11 columns because all those 1000 which it copied were duplicates. Fine. So now we need to remember one thing. Fine. There is a function called in place is equal to true. Right. Now what does in place means? So there are many functions in pandas which basically do not make changes in the original data frame. Right. It is only for the user that the changes will be seen temporarily, but the actual data frame does not make the change happen. So in order to actually modify the original data frame, you have to use this operator or this command, in place is equal to true, right? So this means that, okay, whatever changes you are making. So for example, when I say temp underscore df dot drop duplicates, I am saying in place is equal to true. So basically I am saying that in the temp underscore df data frame, ensure that these changes are permanent, right? Right. So for example, the drop duplicate has another few set of parameters. So by default, it says you can have the keep parameter, right? So keep parameter has three possibilities. First, which is the default one. So it says, for example, if you have, let's say, rainbow, cat, rainbow, rainbow, right? So in the case of first, it will keep the first rainbow and all other duplicates of rainbows will be erased. So it will have rainbow, cat, and that's it. Right, that's first. Another is the last option, drop duplicates except for the last occurrence. So if we have rainbow, cat, rainbow, and rainbow, this will keep kind of the last rainbow. So you will have only cat and rainbow. And false says, basically I don't know why pandas even kept this option, it says drop all duplicates, right? So let us see an example of it. Again, what I'm doing, I'm having the movies underscore data frame, I am appending the same movies to a temporary data frame. So what will happen here? I will have a shape of 2000 cross 11. Now I'm saying drop duplicates in place. So make the changes in place. So basically modify the original data frame, temp underscore df, and keep equal to false. What does keep equal to false do? Drop all the duplicates. So now, as you know, temp underscore df had the same rows repeated twice, right? So it will drop all the duplicates. So it will remove both the copies basically, right? So now if you see temp underscore df dot shape is zero rows because every row had a duplicate of its own. So the keep equal to false removed all the duplicates, right? So there was nothing left in the file, right? So we have a note also, since all rows were duplicates, keep equal to false dropped them, resulting in rows being left over, right? So basically, in my experience, I never used keep equal to false as option. The by default keep equal to first is a default option, so you can just use that. But if you have such a usage where you do not want to have duplicates at all, you can use keep equal to first option. Right? So that's it for this tutorial. Have a good day.